Hey everyone, welcome to another video. In this video, I'm gonna be testing out some new, quite fancy makeup that I recently got. I'm gonna be trying the new Natasha Denona Mini Love Palette, but I'm also gonna be trying Hourglass for the first time. So I'm pretty excited about that, so let's get right into it. So if you haven't been on my channel before, my name is Marley and I love making YouTube videos about makeup and beauty. I love doing looks, swatches, reviews. So if that sounds good to you, then don't forget to subscribe. So let's first get into the palette. I've been waiting for this palette for quite a bit. I actually ordered it quite fast after it released, except the website where I ordered it had like a pre-order and they didn't end up sending it out. So I ended up ordering it from another retailer. So now I got it from another website. So that's why I'm a little bit late with this palette and why I'm not doing like a full dedicated video to it. But I'm still really excited to play around with this palette. So this is the Natasha Denona Mini Love Palette. This came out for Valentine's Day. Of course, that's already quite far behind us, but it's still a very nice palette. So we have 5 shades over here and they are actually named You Are My True Love. So that's quite cute and it makes it also quite easy to remember the shade names. So we actually have 2 mattes, 1 more lilac-y mauve-y shade and 1 darker plummy shade. And then we also have this shimmery toppery shade and 2 metallics over here. 1 is more like a champagne-y shade and this is more like a warmer pink. So I haven't tried this palette yet, but I have tried the Natasha Denona formula before. I have the Mini Glam palette and I'm actually really happy with that one. And so when I saw this one, I saw this color story, I was like, that would be a great way to try some more of Natasha Denona. I really like her mini format. At first when I tried the Mini Glam, I was like, maybe it's not that special, maybe the formula is fine but not worth the money. But I just kept reaching for it. I think it's just an easy formula to use, so that's why I picked this one up. So I can't wait to use this one. Let's get into the look. I will zoom you in a little bit and then we're gonna do some eyeshadow. So I already primed my eyelids. I have to tell you, I didn't wash my brushes before this video because I didn't know that I was gonna have time to film this today. So I cleaned my brushes as well as I could, but I don't have like my favorite brushes here in front of me, but I'm gonna do my best. And one other thing, my skin is so dry. It's like my allergies are kicking me in the butt. It's such nice weather in the Netherlands and I'm really happy about that. It's so sunny, but now my hay fever is also like acting up. So my skin is really dry. So I'm not gonna be too harsh on these products today. I don't think that would be fair. So let me think what I wanna do with this palette. I think I'm first gonna go in with the shade R, so the second lighter matte. And I'm gonna take that on a crease brush that may or may not still have some green on it. Hopefully that's not gonna affect anything. So this is supposed to be like more of a creamy matte formula. I haven't tried that before. That's at least what I heard in other reviews. I feel like when you apply this one to the eye, it's actually warmer than it looks in the pan. It's not a really cool toned light lilac. It definitely has a mauve-y undertone. So I feel like this one would be really easy to wear for darker skin tones as well. That's blending out very easily. I feel like I'm having really good luck with all the eyeshadows I've tried lately. I've tried so many nice palettes, so many nice eyeshadows. Doing the same on the other eye over here. This is going on so easily. And I feel like it's working quite well together with this synthetic brush. Man, I've been waiting so long to try this palette, like so long. At first I was kind of thinking if I should get it at the pre-order on Natasha Denona's website and get like the bundle with everything. But then I waited too long and the pre-order was gone. And then I was like, I will wait till I can get it from a website in Europe. Now it's like a month later and now I got it. But of course you can't always know how it's gonna go. That's looking really good, really nice. That blended out really easily. I'm just gonna swatch that U shade for a second and really see what it actually looks like. Because at this point I haven't swatched anything. This shade looks really like a pink to a bronze. I hope you can kind of see that there. It's a really interesting shade and it also has some texture in there. This one is also a lot warmer than you would think looking at it in the pan. So what I think I'm gonna do is first I'm gonna go in with this plummy purple shade in the crease. That one is a shade Mai, so I'm gonna deepen up the outer corner a bit with this one. This is the shade I was actually looking forward to the most in the palette. I really love the look of this one in swatches. Because it's like a purple, but it's also kind of like nude. It's not like bright, it's really muted. It's a really interesting, nice shade of purple. I don't think I'm gonna make it too dark, but it's quite easy to build this one up. It's quite buildable. And I don't see any patchiness. I feel like these types of shades are sometimes a bit tricky. Tricky to formulate and tricky to work with. But this one is blending out nicely. Blended a little bit better on this side than on this side. But that's fine. Just gonna take a little bit of that lighter shade and blending the edges. This wasn't really like necessary, but it just makes everything blend together a little bit better. So I really like how this crease is looking blended. I think the next shade I'm gonna go in is this shade called Love. I'm gonna apply that to my lid. This is just a regular metallic. It is a bit like a corally pink, a bit of a warmer pink. I think it's quite an interesting choice to put this in the palette. It does add a little bit more variety. And it does make the color story a little bit more interesting, I feel like. This isn't like a blinding metallic or anything like that. It's a nice shade, but it's not like super shiny. That's also what I felt like with the Mini Glam. The metallics were decent, they were nice, but not like extremely foiled or anything like that. So that is a pink shade over there. It's actually quite a bright color. It's quite interesting. And I feel it's like quite a contrast with the rest of the palette. Now I want to go into the shade called You. I want to take this glittery topper and put it on top and see how that works. Because this one has a lot more like shimmer and shine to it. Ooh, I like that. It also tones down the pink a little bit. And you really have that texture there. It gives more dimension to the look. I really like how these two look together. I did get a little bit of fallout from that shimmery shade. Gonna fix that later. This did give some more dimension to the look, I feel. But it's still not like the most shimmery eyeshadow of your life. Like, in comparison with the other shades in the palette, it's more shimmery and dimensional and it has a nice duochrome, but it's still on the subtle side. So now I think I want to go into a little bit more of my, and I'm gonna deepen up the outer third of my lid. Just tying everything together a little bit more and adding some depth here. I was actually going for a little bit more of a soft look, but I don't think it's going too well. But okay, it's the way it is. We're gonna go on with this quite smoky look. I'm gonna go and apply some eyeshadow to the lower lash line. I'm first gonna go in with R, and then I'm gonna deepen that out with my, and just kind of smoke out the lower lash line. What I actually really love about this palette is how tiny it is and how easy it is to lift up and show you. The last two palettes or three palettes that I filmed with were so bulky and so hard to actually show you on camera what shade I was using. So this tiny palette is quite refreshing. I also don't have to think for like 30 minutes about the look I'm gonna do. Not that I usually really do that, but I do think about things a little bit longer with a bigger palette. So now going into the darker shade and kind of smoking out the outer part here. But I have to say it's already looking quite smoky with just that lilac-y mauve shade. Let me think if I still want to do like a shadow liner. Should I or should I not do that? Maybe I can smoke out the upper lash line a little bit more. Since this is already so smoky, and I might as well go with it now. I really love this purple. It's working so well. So now for the finishing touch, let's get into the shade True. And I'm gonna apply this to my inner corner. I'm just gonna take a pencil brush. This is just a bit of a champagne-y metallic. What I really like about this palette is that you have all the shades you need to create a look. You have two mattes. One is more of a transition shade, one you can deepen up with. Then you have two different metallics you can put on the lid, and then you also have a highlighting shade. So you really don't need anything else when you bring this palette or when you reach into this palette. That's not always necessary, of course, with all the makeup, but I do like that you have the option. I'm just gonna take a clean blending brush and blending this a little bit. Although I feel like I shouldn't overdo it with the blending here. Alright, so this was everything for the eyeshadow for now. I think I'm just gonna clean it up, put on some mascara. And then we're gonna move on to the blush that I have and the highlighter that I have. So I'll be right back. So here we are. I just had a mini heart attack because I couldn't find my mascara. But luckily I found it. I always lose my mascara, like all the time. I can never find it. I don't know what I do with it, but I always put it somewhere where I can't see it. So this is the eyeshadow with mascara. I really like how this is looking. Now let's get into the blush. So a little while ago, like 3 months ago, I made a video about all the products that I was still eyeing. And one of the products on that list was this blush by Hourglass. This is the blush in Sublime Flush. I've never tried Hourglass. I was always eyeing their products, but I was always like, is it worth the money? But then I saw this blush in some videos by Ellie Kleins. And when she described the color and she showed it on her face, I was like, maybe this is the one that is worth it to me. So before I apply this, I have to say, it isn't exactly what I expected it to be, and that's because I thought that the packaging was gonna be a bit more like heavy or sturdy or luxurious. It does feel a little bit like plasticky. I was just expecting it to be different. It's not like really bad or really like flimsy or cheap, but I was just expecting something else. I was also kind of expecting the compact to be bigger, I don't know why. But when I look at this color in the pan, it does look really pretty. So this is gonna be like the moment of truth after years and years of watching reviews on Hourglass products but never buying them even though they look so pretty. I have very high hopes. I really hope I'm not gonna be disappointed. But I usually do really like baked blushes and I really like the look of this color. Normally I apply a bronzer first, then I go in with the blush. But to really see the effect of the blush today, I want to put on the blush first. It actually kind of looks like a cool toned pink mixed with like a warm toned pink. I think it's gonna go quite well with this look. I'm using this Kaleidos blush brush. So let's get into it. I'm just gonna take a little bit on my brush and let's start applying that to the cheek. I feel like this is a formula that is quite buildable, but it does really show up on my skin. It isn't like so light that I'm like building and building and building and I'm not seeing anything. I do feel like I have to look at this in some natural light in a moment to really see how I feel about it. I'm gonna build it up to really see the color and the finish, and so you can also really see it on camera. I feel like I've chosen the right color. This is really like a color I would like. I really love pinky blushes, peachy pinky blushes, warm pink blushes, and if they are a little bit shiny, that's my preferred finish. I do see that glow. So I just checked it in some natural lighting because sometimes it's a bit hard to judge products in this light, but I feel like it's just a really natural glowy finish without being like really like shiny or shimmery, and that is what I was kind of hoping for, so that's nice. I think now I'm gonna apply some bronzer real quickly and then see how that looks. Applying that a little bit to the back here. I think I'm just gonna apply the highlighter and then after that I'm gonna apply a little bit more of the blush to bring back that pink. So for the highlighter, I actually bought a highlighter that I've been eyeing for like a year or something like that. So long. And I've heard Kathleen Lights raving about this one in a few of her favorites videos. This is the Clinique Lunar Pop or Flower Pop highlighter. I feel like it has different names because on the box it says Lunar Pop, but here it says Powder Pop Flower Highlighter. I don't know. I think it might be because first it was released for like Lunar New Year or something. So maybe first it was limited edition and now it's permanent. Might be something like that. I don't know. So this is a really pretty highlighter. This is so satisfying to look at. This embossing is just so pretty. And it's like a baked gelée type highlighter, which I really love. So yeah, I've been eyeing this for a long time, but I personally have never spent this amount of money on a highlighter. I don't usually spend more than 20 euros on a highlighter, so that's why it took so long. But in the end, I found a discount code, so I ordered it. I was like, I'm probably gonna love it, so why not splurge this one time? So for me, this is really like a fancy highlight. For you, it might not be, but I'm not really used to spending this money on a highlight. What I did think when I saw this first was that it looked a lot like the Nabla Skin Glazing in Privilege, which is actually one of my favorite highlights. That is this one over here. This is also that Baked Gelée formula. This is also like a champagne that also has some peach and pink in it. But it's also, with this formula and the embossing, a bit hard to see if they are really that similar. But I just wanted to swatch them in this video to see if maybe they could be dupes. Then you know that you don't have to buy the other one when you have one of them. Or maybe it would be a reason for you to try the Nabla one, because that one is quite a bit cheaper. So this is the Nabla highlighter. It's a really beautiful shade. It has some warmth in it, but it's mostly a champagne with some peachy pink undertones. Okay, so I do see a difference. I do think that the Clinique Pop highlighter is a bit lighter. It's a little bit more pearly. So that would be a shade that maybe works better for me when I'm fair. So that's like now. Right now I'm like my fairest. I feel like yesterday was like the first time I saw sun in months. Last week it was such cold winter weather and now it's so warm. So now I see the sun, but before that for a long time, nope, not at all. So I feel like these highlighters have kind of like a similar undertone, but they're not like exact dupes. The flower one is definitely a shade lighter. So maybe if you have a lighter skin tone and you didn't know if Privilege would be for you, but you like the idea of it, you could check out the Clinique highlighter. So let me just grab my highlighter brush and I'm gonna go into the highlighter. It's kind of sad to destroy the beautiful embossing, but I always want to use my products. That definitely has a similar formula to the Skin Glazing highlighters. It's like this soft, natural looking glow, but I think you can build it up. It's like it blends into the skin. It isn't powdery, it doesn't lay on top of the skin. I have to say I'm a bit relieved that the two highlighters are not like exactly the same. I didn't want my first splurge highlighter to be a dupe for something I already had. That looks really nice and glowy, quite natural. Definitely a little bit lighter on the skin than the Skin Glazing one. By the way, I almost always use the Real Techniques setting brush as my highlighter brush. Been using this one for years. Let me just build that up a little bit. That one looks so good. I really like Baked Gelée highlighters. If you have any recommendations for Baked Gelée highlighters, leave them down below. I would love to hear them. So that is looking very good. Very nice. Very happy with that one. So now let's get into the blush once again. I'm just gonna apply a little bit of blush. I'm just gonna apply that on top to bring back a bit of that pink. And to tie everything in together. I think this is a really nice pink shade that would go with a lot of the makeup looks I do. But it would also be really nice for spring. I really like how my cheeks are looking right now. So nice and glowy. Now let me just fix my brows and my lips. I don't have any new lip product, so I'm gonna do that off camera. And then I will be back to show you the finished look and to tell you what I think about these products. So this is the finished look. I'm actually really enjoying it. I really love this eyeshadow. I love how my cheeks look. It's looking very good. Now let's get into the products. Let's get into my first impression thoughts. First, the palette. I really enjoy this color story. I really enjoy the quality. I thought the shadows worked very nicely. The shimmers aren't like your most special shimmers ever, but it was also not really what I was expecting. They are just very nice, decent shimmers that work well, but they won't be like the most special ones. I think I enjoyed the mattes in here the most. They worked very well. They're very beautiful colors that I feel like I would use a lot. I really like this packaging, this bright pink chrome type of packaging I really like. And in general, I just feel like these 5 pens look and feel really luxurious. It looks quite heavy. It looks like it's good quality plastic. So that's also something I really enjoy about these palettes. They just feel very sturdy, very well made. So my first impression impression thoughts are really positive. I really like this palette, I really enjoyed it. And I definitely think it's a good one to check out if you like pinks and purples and if you're interested in a Natasha Denona formula. I think her minis are such a good place to start. If you want to see if her brand is something for you, it's $25 or 25 euros. And that's really not that bad for the nice quality you get. I don't know if I would really spend my money on a bigger palette. Maybe I will do so in the future if I really see the perfect color story. But for now, I think I'm fine with just having the minis. I am thinking maybe I should buy the mini nude. At first, I thought maybe it was a bit too warm, but I think it might work for me. So I'm kind of eyeing that one. Do you think I should buy it? I'm thinking about it. So next up we have the Hourglass blush. My first impressions are really positive. I think it's a really pretty color, a really pretty natural sheen on the cheeks. But I have to say, I have to use this one and try this one out a little bit more before I can really say that it's like worth the price tag. Like 40 euros, that is a lot of money. That isn't what I paid for it in the end because I had a discount code, but it is quite pricey for a blush, so I'm not entirely sure yet. Even though I really like it, I also have to take into account the price. So I will try it out a bit more and then I will let you know if I actually think it's worth it. My first impressions are really positive though. I do feel like it's something I'm really gonna be using a lot because of the finish and the color. So yeah, I'm quite positive about this one. I'm quite happy with it so far. And last up, we have the Clinique highlighter, the Big Gelée Lunar Pop or Flower Pop highlighter. Really love this one. I really love the finish on the skin. It's really natural but still very glowy. It blends in very well. I just really love this one. I just think it's so cute. This is a type of makeup when I look at it, I'm like, oh, it's so pretty. So that's what I really like about it as well. But of course, it's not just about the embossing or the packaging. I just really love the effect this gives. I really like this color. It's not like your basic champagne. There's just a little bit of pink and peach in this, which I really like. So I really enjoyed this one. In general, I'm really happy with everything that I tried today. Everything worked out very well. So is it worth it to buy some more expensive makeup sometime? Maybe it is, but I guess it kind of depends on you and on what you're splurging on. I feel like everyone has their own thing that they want to spend a little bit more money on than maybe other people would. I'm at least really happy with these products, but I still feel like you don't need to spend and a lot of money to have nice makeup. So that's also something I want to say. Don't ever feel like you have to buy more expensive makeup. Just buy what fits your budget. And don't ever feel like you have to buy anything. So I'll probably come back to these products in a future video. I will try them out a bit more and I will tell you in my roundup review of new makeup what like my final review, my final verdict is, because of course after a first impression you don't really know everything. I always feel like you have to try products out a little bit more to really know if you like them. But yeah, so far I'm really happy with them. So that was everything for today's video. Let me know in the comments what you thought about the final look, what you thought about these products. Like this video if you liked it, don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in my next one. Bye bye!